Aloha, I'm geologist Philip Ong, sharing a Kīlauea video brief.
In this report, new outlets and lake changes.
Since Kīlauea's most recent eruption began on September 29th, 2021, lava has filled the then 112-acre, or 45-hectare, Halemaumau crater by 213 feet, or 65 meters, bringing a lava lake and the west vent into direct public view within Hawaii Volcanoes National Park. In the first week of November, output slowed enough that the active lava lake surface almost entirely crusted over, before returning to its previous stronger levels after less than a day. Since then, the spatter cone has sprung two new lava outlets from its base near the western crater wall. These have fed new smaller streams of lava around the cone and down into the lake, one on each side of the still active original entry point, which has been seen to be fluctuating in vigor. The new outlets have been intermittently strengthened over time, first in the north, but also in the south, visible as multiple entry points into the lava lake in a surface circulation pattern once the upper parts of their pathways are crusted over. Gas emissions have mirrored lava activity, both in their dips and peaks beyond the recently common 2,000 to 5,000 tons per day range. The area of visible active lava has decreased to 17 acres or 7 hectares, now covering only 11% of the innermost crater floor, and yet the eruption continues to add to the mass of lava beneath the hardened crust, making up the other 89% of its area, lifting it up and oozing out beyond its farthest edges. Some of these peripheral ooze-up flows are now slowly covering a growing area on the lowest downdrop block to the north. While time lapses show the dramatic filling of the crater over the past month and a half, the combined output of this eruption and the previous 5-month eruption only adds up to about 8.5% of the volume loss during a 2018 summit collapse. Unlike 2018, there are no signs of further magma movement from the summit into either rift zone. Instead, the September 2021 eruption seems to be following the pattern of the last summit eruption beginning in December 2020, especially in its output rates, active lava area, and total volume erupted, though it has currently produced 15% less lava over the same duration. In other words, smaller than the last eruption, so far. The new outlets from the base of the West Vent Cone mark the latest evolution of its eruptive style, from low fountaining with episodic bursts during its first few weeks, to low roiling and spatter bursts during the last 2 weeks, perhaps owing to its submergence under the filling lake since October 3rd. The spatter cone surrounding the vent was initially carried upwards by the filling lake, before beginning to be drowned by rising lava. The original spillway from the horseshoe-shaped cone gradually crusted over and constricted during low effusion periods, eventually restricting the output before the appearance of the new outlets, and the latest small changes within the overall progression of the eruption. That's all this week. To support our productions, please like, share, and subscribe. Mahalo.